Okay, so we're here with FIFA Head of Technical Development, Mr. Jurg Nepfer, in Trinidad and Tobago, Port of Spain to be exact, for the FIFA Technical Director's course. Mr. Nepfer, tell us a little bit more of the purpose of such a workshop here in Port of Spain.
Yes, the purpose of this workshop is to bring new technical directors together.
From the region, this guy in the Caribbean member associations, we have 8 member associations, technical directors here. We want to elaborate this workshop on four pillars. One is to know more about the situation of the TDs in these different member associations. Number two, we want to give them some tools for their daily business. We elaborated a handbook for technical directors on this. So we hope that with this handbook they can work a little bit easier their daily routines. Number three is we will have bilateral meetings with each of the technical directors in order to elaborate specific and tailor-made assistance for them for the development of football in these countries. And number four is we want to do practical analysis, as we are doing it right now in the stadium, in the Hasley Crawford Stadium. On one side, match analysis. Number two is training observation. Number three is coaching, education, observation. And always from the point of view of a technical director. So with this, we hope that we can improve the knowledge of technical directors in their member associations. Of course, it is part of a process. It's not an isolated event. We want to be closer to these TDs. We want to support them with a specific mentorship program and concept. We want to do also some monitoring for them in order to really to support these TDs in their work for the development of football in the specific countries.
And so tell us, based on your experience and from a FIFA level, do you think that across different confederations and different MAs, the roles and responsibilities of a TD may vary? Or is there now something where it's something set by FIFA that all MAs must follow these guidelines in terms of the privileges or the roles and functions of a TD?
I mean, anyway, each country and each member association is different. But of course, we want to ensure that the technical directors, who are for us the architect of the development of football in a country, they have the right status, they have the right empowerment, they have the right setup in the department, they have the right resources from the human resources point of view, but also financial resources. We insisted since 2009 that each and every federation who wants to benefit from our development programs, they have a technical director in place. Of course, in 2009 it was not yet that developed as it is now. Now I think we have reached a level where we can be quite happy. Of course, there is still room for improvement, but sometimes the biggest challenges are the leaderships of the member associations, who do not have the awareness of the importance of a technical director. Many of these federations, they talk about the national team, they think about the national team, but they don't think about what is there or what has to be there in order to have a national team in place. So we're always talking about this technical or this development pyramid, starting with the basis, the quantity, the growing the game with grassroots activities, boys and girls in schools, clubs, etc. Then youth football, elite youth football, academies, then senior football, adults football. Without this pyramid, it's very difficult to have consistent success. And the technical directors, of course, they are playing a vital role in this. And that's why also we are always saying and insisting that there has to be a close cooperation between the national coach and the technical director. There is no boss of each other. The two are working on the same level, have the same level of importance. Of course, they are different targets. The national coach is preparing the next game, and of course the TD is preparing the future of football in the federation.
have you seen, or is there, to your knowledge, a growing trend of a separate technical director for women's football across MAs, or do you all see it all coming men and women's game under your main technical director?
Yeah, I mean, when we talk about football, it's always football for men and women. So, but of course, we also want to insist that women's football is more developed. It depends a bit on the size and of the philosophy of a member association. I think it's fine if you have a technical director who has the understanding of for women's football as well, but then under his guidance there is a specific department for women's football headed by a specialist in women's football. Can be a former player, can be a coach, but we would support that the women's football department is part of the technical division. Of course, there are big federations where they have women's football totally separated from men's football. They have the exactly the same structure for women's football as well as for men's football. But I think in the countries we are even having here, I think it would make the best of sense to have a strong women's football department under a strong technical director and a strong technical division.
Tell us, what would you hope to see come out of this workshop this week? What would you hope finally in terms of the real incentive or the ultimate motive for this workshop?
Yeah, we hope of course that each of the TDs who are present here, they can benefit, they can take something home which can improve the level, their personal level, but also then the level of football development. We also hope that we can assist them with the tools we are providing, in order that they can do their job better. We also hope that with the confidence we can give them, they have a bit more empowerment, that they can also talk to the general secretaries and the presidents in order what they have learned and how important FIFA thinks a technical director is. But as I said before, it's a part of a process, and so it's not an isolated event we are doing here. We don't want to leave the TDs just going away from here, and then we don't take care about them anymore. So we want to elaborate the mentorship program, probably also together with CONCACAF, in order to be closer to the federation, also to see the impact we are having with this technical director's course, and in order that the whole situation, the raising the awareness of the MA leadership for the work of a technical director, importance of football development in a federation. So we hope that with this program, not only with this course, but then also with all the other courses we are doing worldwide, the status and the position of a technical director can improve, and with that, of course, development of football in the different countries as well.